And I'm here with Carter Malchoy, who is one of the people that's really, I've been really looking forward to talking to you, Carter, because you are making it, you're making it go right in this time of tremendous economic distress. You've cornered a niche market that I think, well, it's obviously something that nobody's looked at, and it's time they did. And that is using ants and other insects around the house to save money on other energy costs by having them do some of the simple tasks that either people do themselves, or they use electronic devices or electrical or even, you know, mechanical devices to do.
Yeah. The insect world is a world that biologists have studied for centuries. And the old adage that most insects can lift 10 times their weight is never more important now in these economic times.
Mm-hmm. And you work in the lumber industry, so you've been around a lot of termites and ants and critters like that.
Yeah, I am no stranger to things crawling, flying, or biting or sucking.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, of course, many of us look at those creatures and think to ourselves, "Well, you know, I want to do whatever I can to avoid them, get them out of my house." But you've actually taken great pains to get insects into your home and into your workplace to run some of the machinery.
Yes, collectively, they work very well. Obviously, individually, absolutely nothing's going to get done
by
a single ant.
Yeah, so a person, anybody listening to this program who maybe has a hardy-looking ant,
it's a waste of your time and energy to put a single ant to work. Mm-hmm. But now if you get a colony, and if you get them all marching in the same direction, things you can see the differences right away, and that's savings to your wallet.
Carter, you showed me one of your workshops, just one of several workshops that you have, and there was a conveyor belt that I just thought was jaw-dropping, and you told me you had 15 colonies of ants. You had close to a million ants, each walking in, looked like lockstep to me. I mean, I didn't even know they were ants. It looked like a piece of burlap. They were just a piece of gray fabric. They were all moving in unison.
Right.
And they were turning a small turbine.
Right. And that powered my old hi-fi system.
Mm-hmm.
And it's amazing, the animal kingdom. I don't know. I think there's a hum and an ebb and a flow to anything. But I think if the universe is moving, it's moving at 33 and a third.
Mm-hmm.
And somehow that translates even to insects. And the money I save on having those insects.
How much do you think it is in terms of kilowatt hours?
I have not bothered to figure it out.
Uh-huh.
I'm just secure in the luxury of knowing that I'm listening to music. I'm listening to quality hi-fi.
Uh-huh.
For zero cost.
And you're sharing that music. I noticed you had the music playing in the room where the little ants were doing their thing. And do you think that makes a difference? Do they respond differently to different kinds of music?
I have not noticed that they've responded differently. I just know that they're happier.
Mm.
I sense.
How do you tell? Just out of curiosity, for not being a person that works with ants or even really could tell you which ant is which on an ant. But how do you know they're happy?
I sense a spirited feeling from them, and it's audible in that sometimes it's a little. It's about 34 and a third, and I'm a big.
They march
fan.
A little faster.
They march a little faster, depending on the music.
Mm-hmm.
But all music makes them move quicker. But I'm a big Roy Rogers fan, and I can tell you when it's moving too fast. Roy does not sound. I have a keen ear for that.
Hmm. Well, of course, you've got these ants and other insects, earthworms, gypsy moths. You've got ladybugs, sow bugs, what we used to call little roly bugs. You've got them all doing various things around your house. And so you're not relying on solar power. You're not relying on electricity from some hydroelectric dam, although there are a lot of them nearby you. There are a lot of opportunities, especially in the desert where you live. But you're relying totally on bug power.
Bug power. And I'll tell you, a funny irony and a funny story is that when you flip on the light and you see the cockroaches scamper, that scampering that they have, I've devised a Lucite treadmill. The scampering powers the light that you switch on to make them scamper. Isn't that funny?
Well, so it's a kind of a Mobius strip almost.
It is.
Of a perpetual motion machine.
It is.
Wow, that is incredible. And of course, you showed me also the moth engine that you've developed that has moths going around and around, electric light that they don't get close enough so that it burns them or incinerates them, but it will actually creates friction that, that powers your golf cart.
Right. That's it's a moth tied to minuscule monofilament, which gives a drag coefficient, which creates the friction, which powers the golf cart.
You make it sound so easy, but of course, if someone just starting out, you learned a lot through trial and error.
I did. Yeah. And also I had a lot of insight going back to the epiphany I had when the hydroelectric dam went in.
And what was that?
It was just an epiphany I had.
Oh. All right. Well, I imagine it was a private sort of epiphany that you don't feel comfortable sharing. Or?
I don't talk about it as much due to the injury that accompanied the.
Oh, I understand. Well, okay. Well, let's not dig down. Now, for other people that are looking to try to save money and bring down expenses.
It was a head trauma.
Oh. Well, thanks for sharing that.
Well, I feel as though it should be known.
Yeah.
It accounts for a lot of my brilliance.
Hmm. Well, I've heard about that sometimes a person will be struck by lightning or be hit by a crowbar and will suddenly...
I'm much smarter than anyone struck by lightning, I'll tell you that much.
Well, it's good to know.
I don't want to brag
or
anything.
People struck
by lightning are simpletons compared to the vast knowledge that I have harboring the useful power of insects.
Well, you certainly know a lot about insects, and I notice you have... some kind of multi-legged creature on your clothing right now. In fact, now that I look at it, your jacket is made entirely of some sort of moving mass of insect life.
It is. It's a combination of praying mantises.
Oh yeah.
If you look closely
enough. Yes, I see the little
praying mantis and.
Are those wasps?
Yeah, wasps. Wasps, of course.
That doesn't make you nervous?
No, not at all. They're completely neutral.
Oh, they're neutral wasps.
They're neutral wasps. They're born without the ability to sting due to the fact that their hive was so close to the hydroelectric dam.
Once again, bringing you back to your epiphany. Did I say epiphany?
Yeah,
Bringing you back to your epiphany again. Well, do you have any words of advice for people that want to start to do this sort of thing? Would you advise people in cities, for example, to do it?
I would advise people to consult with me.
And you have quite a website.
I have a great website. I would advise them to come out and see what I've done. And if you want to, it's going to be something that will consume you. And you'll be set back financially at the top. Severely.
Really?
You'll be subject of ridicule. You'll be ostracized. Very often, a lot of family members will leave you.
Wow.
People, friends.
This is with or without a head trauma? This is what they face?
This is exactly what they face. I don't recommend the head trauma. However, I will say that it has something to do with my keen insight and brilliance.
Yeah, you mentioned that, and I'm glad to know more about that. Well, listen, I can see that the insects on your that are your jacket are seem to be prompting you to leave. They're dragging you out of the booth, and I want to thank you for spending this time with us, and please come back again.
I brought something for you.
Oh, all right.
It's a common house termite.
Oh, just one?
Just one.
Okay.
For now.
Ah.
You'll see what I'm talking about later.